And now, Fitzy's, manufacturers of odd socks for busy politicians, bring you Dr. Don's Full Frontal Radio Show.
He'll never get away with this.
This week starring the Superpoofs, Desi Fitz-Eakin and Eakin Fitz-Desi in Stop Press, the story that takes the lid off the Sunday newspapers. Join us now in the editor's office when Scoop Little bursts in.
I say, Ed.
What is it, Scoop?
I've just been down to the composing room and I've settled upon a headline that tells just about everything.
Oh, yeah? How does it go?
It goes, sleazy does it, said nude leather-clad vicar in orgy of body spanking, while teenage surgeon priest in sex change mercy dash to palace corgi. Wife waits.
Don't fail to join us next week on this channel for the continuing story of Dr. Don's Full Frontal Radio Show. Mighty in drama, mighty in passion, mighty innocuous. The steaming story of a dog, and a cat, and a bunny rabbit, and a green frog you're really loving to simply die of
pleasure. Yeah, well, I met you.
Six and a half minutes after 1 o'clock, yeah, yeah. A Daffy Dr. Don's Wacky Weekend Show.
Hello.
That's Frankie Miller and the Honky Tonk Blues. Hey, you know, our number is 695-5544, and our mystery voice contest is coming along in a moment, following which we'll have great adventure for the kids, so stand by.
Here comes our mystery voice contest.
Wipe the life for me.
The ingredients: 8 ounces of salt and pepper, 1 large breadcrumb, 1 egg, skinned and trimmed, 1/4 pint of fat. And then, having got all that, this is what you do. You put the 1/4 pint of water through the mincer. Twice.
10,000 chances to get it right at 695-5544, so take it away, kiddies.
Hello, children.
Hello.
Hello. Well, last week we showed you how to be a gynecologist, and this week on How to Do It, we're going to learn how to play the flute, how to split the atom, how to construct box girder bridges, and how to irrigate the Sahara and make vast new areas cultivatable. But first, here's Jackie to tell you how to rid the world of all known diseases.
Hello, Alan.
Hello, Jackie.
Well, first of all, become a doctor and discover a marvellous cure for something, and then when the medical world really starts to take notice of you, you can jolly well tell them what to do and make sure they get everything right so there'll never be diseases anymore.
Thanks, Jackie. That was great.
Fantastic.
Now, how to play the flute? Well, you blow in one end and move your fingers up and down the outside.
Great, Alan. Well, next week we'll be showing you how black and white people can live together in peace and harmony, and Alan will be over in Moscow showing you how to reconcile the Russians and the Chinese. Till then, cheerio.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
My bones, you know.
Steinman and a rock and roll dreams come true. Thank you very much, Grandpa. Can I remind you again that later on we'll have the story of the brush? Oh, I feel it coming thick and fast. We'll also have Ireland's most exciting commentator, J. Wendell Armbruster, with another consuming thought. Right now it's hello to Robert McCarthy, sending his love all the way from Ballyhydrin this afternoon. And he's sending it to his lady friend. She is... Patricia McCarthy, I've got it now, yes. And Patricia is not far away. She's in Glenamaddy and waiting in agonized anticipation for the satellite love communication. You've asked for CCR, Robert, for her, and we'll have that for you after we hear from them. Them being CCR and the Stuff Gang.
Today, much more stuff going on.
Did you know that a moron has an IQ of between 0 and 25, an imbecile 25 and 65, and an idiot, or B.P. Fallon, 65 and 100?
Well, that's about it, Stuff fans. We'll have more for you at another time. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
All right, what?
What a great song, Johnny Fogerty and CCR. And that's a track you'll find wrapped around the Creedence Gold LP, so buy it today, if possible. Well, while you were listening to this show last week, and I know you were, you'll remember I played you the first ever BBC jingle from Auntie Aggie's show.
And what a reaction!
Millions of letters and telegrams saying, please, Don, can we have some more of that exciting stuff? So I thought, why not? And during the week, I dug into my box of bits, and I came across an American Drink and Drive jingle, and also a Dynasty jingle recorded from Kiss 108 FM in Boston. You'll really enjoy these, and I should mention that for anybody standing by with a tape recorder, I have to tell you that what you're doing is illegal. However, having said that, it's time for you to take your finger off the pause button.
Hello. Let me tell you about myself. I used to be a drunk, a chronic drunk driver. In the 10 years between my first arrest and having my license revoked, I racked up 19 major traffic violations. I caused 6 serious accidents, injured 3 people beside myself, and had my license suspended twice. I was still driving and drinking. And then, one night I was driving home after work and I had a few and I hit this kid on a bicycle. He died before they could get him any help. He was just 11, a little younger than my oldest boy. I'm living with that now. I was too drunk to see him then, but I can see him now. And I remember.
Isn't it time you got what you wanted?
Go on. Indulge yourself.
Dynasty.
Stimulation. That's the word.
Make their everyday passions your daily affair.
Play!
You're my wife. You do what I tell you to do when I tell you to do it.
The risks.
All right, I sold myself. But let me tell you this. I'm ready to let the brass ring go.
The romance.
Oh, I want you more than anything that I've ever wanted.
I love you, I swear.
The riches.
I taught you how to use sex for gain.
You've made a prostitute out of me.
The saga of the men with millions.
You're still Blake Carrington with the big bucks and the unholy power.
And the women with a few numbers of their own.
You know something, Alexis? You completely and thoroughly surprise and disgust me.
Have I hit a nerve in that oh-so-serene body of yours?
Dynasty. See it daily, because once a week is not enough.
And now, let's slow down the moon.
Thank you.
That's just about going to do with me and another weird and wonderful wacky weekend show from Daffy Town. If you're not confused, you're misinformed, but let me remind you that the program has been committed in cold blood by yours truly, aided and abetted by Pat Morley, and a plea of not guilty has been handed in by Carl McKay. Thank you for listening. I said thank you for listening. And this is the great big mahogany desk at 2FM, where we mean business, because it's exactly, almost, in fact it is, 2 o'clock.